Welcome everybody. I'm Cam D'Souza. This is Locker Talk, and today we're going to begin into a Jakobi Meyers film analysis. And the question that we have at hand today is Jakobi Meyers the next generation of slot receivers for the New England Patriots? Is he the next Wes Welker? Is he the next Julian Edelman? We'll have that question answered at the end of this video, so please stay tuned. Now, when we think of our stereotypical slot receiver, we think of an individual who looks 5'9", 5'11", is around 200 pounds, is quicker than fast, produces yards after the catch. We think of the Cole Beasleys of the world. We think of Wes Welker, of course, and we think of Anthony Gonzalez from back in the day, and Brandon Stokely from back in the day. And when we think of Jakobi Meyers, we think of this tall, 6'2", 200 pounds, gangly, not very athletic wide receiver. And to give you some stats for that, Jakobi Meyers, and this is according to Mock Draft Table, Jakobi Meyers ran a 4.63 40, a 7.073 cone, and a 4.23 20-yard shuttle. If we were to compare that to one of our slot receivers that we've previously had, Julian Edelman, 4.52 40, 6.62 3 cone, 3.92 20-yard dash. Blows him out the water. If we were just to eyeball Jakobi Meyers, we would say, no way in hell is that guy a slot receiver. No way. But when we look at the film says otherwise. The way this dude plays, and the way he gets open, and the way he gets open underneath, truly, truly special. I love watching this guy play. And to put some stats on it, to wrap up the stats, because you know me, I'm a film guy. When we're talking about football, stats ain't the way. What does the film say? Last year, 59 catches, 729 yards, 0 receiving touchdowns, 2 passing touchdowns. 2019, 26 receptions, 359 yards, 0 receiving touchdowns. I'm sure he's going to break that in the 2021 season. But as far as Jakobi Meyers and what he does well, and these are the things that we're going to get into in the film. His route running, and a lot of it's going to be based off his route running. Route running is amazing. The way this dude runs routes and sets himself up to get open, and that's one thing about him. They should nickname him the Chris Hogan 7-11. Dude is always open on every single play, pretty much. But his route running, truly, truly special. Knowing where the defenders are and how to get open. Knowing how to use leverage to get open. Really, really next level kind of stuff. The only con that I really have on Jakobi Meyers is that his yards after the catch really isn't all that great. I mean, part of it's due to lack of opportunity, which, to preface this entire film analysis, this is the least amount of film I've utilized for a film analysis. I mean, we're talking about a dude who had a few snaps here and there in 2019, didn't really play full games, didn't get a full opportunity in 2020 until halfway through the year when Edelman was out. And on top of that, played on a extremely limited offense that basically ran spot 20 times a game. Cue the spot compilation. And for those of you who don't know, spot is a pass concept where one individual, which was Jakobi Meyers, 9 times out of 10, ran a hook, somebody ran a curl, and then he had a flat. Hopefully I can get that up on the screen. Hopefully I'm technologically savvy enough. But regardless of all those factors, Jakobi Meyers really, really liked this player. And let's get into the film. Let's see if he can be the next Wes Welker, or Julian Edelman? We talked about the difference between being a body catcher and a natural hands catcher. And Meyers is a body catcher, which is fine. That's completely fine. Just means that you want to stick it on him as opposed to letting him reach out and go get it, because that's not who he was. That's not who Wes Welker was. Wes Welker is very similar. If you're a natural hands catcher, you're going to flip your hands around. You're going to attack that ball, as opposed to how he's a body catcher. He's going to try to cradle that ball right into his body. Now let's go to the Chargers game. We got a decent amount of clips from the Chargers game. Liked a lot of the film. The Chargers are just playing cover one hole. We got Jakobi Meyers lined up in the right slot, and we got Casey Hayward playing him tight. It's hard to press someone who's in the slot because they're off the line of scrimmage. Fun fact, it's just all about distance. You have a little bit more room to create separation. But just love this initial part of this route. It really love it. Because he's playing him tight. He's not really going to press him. It's hard to press guys in the slot. And he's going to take a nice angle in on this route because of the way Hayward's playing him. He's not going to try to break his ankles. And he's going to do a great job of fighting through the contact, stacking back on top of him. That's the most important part of this route, is the fact that he stacks back on top of Hayward, which is why he takes that path so far inside, just stack on top of him, break this route out, and then make a great adjustment on the ball, because crappy ball. And you can already see it in these first few plays to revisit the fact of he gets open with his route running, not with his athleticism. And there's a difference because if you're getting open with route running, like you saw on these first few plays, and you're going to continue to see on the rest of the plays that I show you, it's the way he's running the route, the way he's setting up his leverage and the cornerback's leverage to which he can break on the route to be open. To where if he's just trying to get open with his athleticism, you can use this out route, for example. If you're an athletic wide receiver, you're trying to get open with your athleticism as opposed to your route running, you're probably just going to book it off the line, get your body into the defender, and then just break it out sharply. Plain and simple. As opposed to where you see Jakobi Meyers run this route, he's taking an inside stem, stacking on top of this cornerback, and then breaking out. Big difference. And to go into our next play, this is what I'm talking about, understanding coverages and understanding what the defense is trying to do and using that to get open. Because if we run this play right now, all this is going to look like is a simple post to the untrained eye. But this is a seven-step glance. Everyone loves throwing a glance because it's just a quick concept, three-step drop for the quarterback, ball out. That's the thing with the glance. Ball's out. You're finding the hole in the defense. Because if it's zone, you're throwing between two backers, ideally. And if it's man, the wide receiver just has to win. This is cover three from what I'm looking at. And when we're looking at this pre-snap, we see we got press initially. We got the safety trying to come off the edge, which Myers is on the right side. We got the safety probably coming right off the edge, or he's bailing. One of the two. You got two defenders right in the middle of the field. In him being smart and understanding what the defense is doing, and this is going to look like such a small and minute detail, but when you take this outside angle on this glance route, because initially your glance is just seven steps straight, break, and as soon as you're breaking, the ball is on you. But being that he takes this outside angle, look at the hole this creates. And we're going to freeze frame it right here. Because on this break, I mean, ideally you want the ball out a little bit, like probably a half second earlier. But I mean, that's a very small detail. And look how close that linebacker gets to actually tipping this ball and intercepting this ball. That's Patrick Queen, one of the best young linebackers in the league. And by him taking this outside release on this glance is what creates this play to be open. Because if he just did his regular glance where he's just coming up, he's on the inside of the numbers, because you see this play, he's on the outside of the numbers. If you just run straight, he'd be inside the numbers. Then you'd be trying to throw in between these two guys, and you have the safety over there, be a whole congested mess. But by him taking this outside release, creates a throwing window, easy completion, easy first down. That's great football. Great football. And you see this so many times. Jakobi Meyers is just a great football player. He understands the game. He knows how to get open. He knows what everyone else is doing, and he knows how to put himself in the best position possible. I love this. I love great football players who know the game. To get into our next play, gonna go to the Dolphins game. We got Meyers lined up initially, deuce left in the slot. He's going to motion over to the right. This is just cover one by the Dolphins. And we got Xavier Howard on him this time. Top level corner. One of the best cornerbacks in the entire league. I mean, this is a hard route to cover, first of all. So great coverage by Howard. And this is really just great offense. Because you see Meyers take their first initial come up 2, 3 yards. And his footwork at the beginning of this play is just lovely. And his footwork at the start of this play to set him up and get open is just lovely. Because you see that left foot jab out to set up the jab back in with the right, to set up the cut back in with the right. Get just a little bit of separation that he needs. Good ball by Cam. You didn't see that many times last year. Turn up, get up the field. Pick up first down. Great coverage and good offense. Just all around really good play. I love the fact of how many yards after the catch he gets on this, which contradicts the yards after the catch con that I was talking about, and we're gonna get into right now. But I'm gonna show you what I mean. Because with him in yards after the catch, he's not an Edelman type where he's gonna make somebody miss. And we're gonna see that on this play. He's more of get upfield, pick up as many yards as he can, and fall forward. Where that's fine and that's good. It's just a different way to game plan. So you're not going to try to throw bubbles to him. You're not going to try to get him the ball in space and just let him make a play, which is fine. That's not a bad thing at all. You see that right here. So we got trips left. We're going to see Meyers in the bubble here. And Meyers' job on this bubble, because you see pre-snap, you know he's going to have to make somebody miss. I mean, you see Casey Hayward come off the edge and have the safety replace, which I mean, that's partially another reason why this play didn't work as well, because you have the safety coming in full speed to come and make the play. He has a lot of built-up speed on this. But regardless, on this play, you're throwing a bubble. Meyer's job is to make one guy miss, and this is the guy that he needs to make miss, and he doesn't, which is why it's a gain of 1 yard. Just not great at making defenders miss, which goes back to his athleticism. Not very quick, shifty, great at changing gears, which is, it's not a bad thing. It's fine. This last play, I just like, because he made him go right into his own guy, which it seems like he did it on purpose. It seems like he knew what he was doing. It wasn't an accident. So that's why I'm going to give him a little bit of props on this. But again, we saw this on the Casey Hayward play, where he takes that initial strong inside release. And look how tight he is to this linebacker. He's rubbing him just to get open. And Cam misses it, but just great awareness. Doesn't happen on every play, but funny to see when it does happen. That's going to wrap it up for this film analysis. For those of you who made it this far in the video, I truly, truly appreciate it. And to answer our question, I think we all know, yes, I truly believe that Jakobi Meyers is going to be the next generation slot receiver for the New England Patriots. He has a unique ability to just get open. And I just really love watching this dude play because he doesn't do it with athleticism. He's not that athletic, as we saw. Just creative player, and I can't get enough of watching this guy. I truly hope we're looking at him like we do at Welker and like we do at Edelman 5 to 10 years down the road. And I could be wrong. I could be dead wrong. He may not be able to get on the field in 2021. But I hope you're with me to find out. And if you're not already subscribed, please help a brother out. Subscribe. But I'll catch y'all next time.